it's Ingrid. Welcome to my channel again, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make these awesome gooey butter cookies that I found online. I'll link the recipe down below. I love these cookies. I make them all the time for whenever I have to bake for something. And yeah, let's get started. The first thing that you're going to need is an electric mixer, unless you have ripped muscles and you want to hand beat everything, but ain't nobody got time for that. And then the next things that you're gonna need are the cake mixes that you wanna use, and I am making 4 batches of cookies for this video. So the first one I'm making is a Duncan Hines Blue Velvet cake mix, and I'm gonna be making 2 Pillsbury Funfetti cake mixes because these are the best, am I right, ladies? And I'm making a Pillsbury Moist Supreme Strawberry, and the other ingredients that you're gonna need to make these cookies are some eggs, some cream cheese, some butter, and some powdered sugar. And again, I'll leave the exact measurements for everything down below, as well as the link to the website that gave me this awesome recipe. Well, because I am making all 4 batches in this video, it's just gonna be a lot easier to mix all the basic stuff and then separate all the basic stuff so that they can become beautiful, tasteful, gooey butter cookie creations in separate bowls. So I'm just gonna mix all the basic stuff together right now in this big, huge bowl. And you want your butter and your cream cheese to be room temperature because that makes it easier to mix with your electric mixer. So I have 4 packages of room temperature cream cheese, and you need a 1/2 cup of butter for each recipe. So I have 2 cups of butter right here, room temperature as well, and you need to cream those together first. Then you're gonna take your electric mixer and you're gonna mix together your cream cheese and butter, and my mouth just got really stuffy. Excuse that. Excuse you? After you have your butter and your cream cheese all mixed together, it'll look something like this. You gotta add in all your eggs, and for each recipe it's just 1 egg, but because I am making 4 batches of these cookies, I have 4 eggs right here. Then after you add in all of your eggs, you just mix it together with your electric beater to make sure that everything is all smooth and creamy, and that's all you need besides the cake mix.
And this is what your mixture should look like.
Alright, so if you're only making 1, by the way, excuse Max right now, he's playing right over there with one of his toys, so if you hear squeaking just like that or growling, it is Max. There you go. So because I'm not making 1 batch, I'm making 4 batches. This excludes to anyone that's making only 1 batch. So I have to take all this and I'm separating it into this bowl by 1/2, and then in 1/2 again into these 2 bowls. Since I'm already making 2 things of Funfetti, I thought it'd just be easier to keep this bowl as a Funfetti bowl. I have 2 bowls that are hopefully even of this mixture. And now this one is for Funfetti. And now I'm gonna split this one in 1/2 again. So this bowl is going to be blue velvet and this bowl is going to be strawberry. Now that I have my, now that I have my 3 even bowls of mixture, I'm going to start setting up to do Funfetti. So now all I did was pour all of the cake mix into this big bowl of mixture for the Funfetti, and you just want to stir it all together. You're actually supposed to use your electric mixer for this part too, but because I am making 4 different batches, technically 3, I didn't want to have to wash my electric mixer in between each batch, so I am just going to be hand stirring all of these last little parts for these cookies. Then after you finish mixing up all of your dough, all you're going to do is stick this in the fridge for 1 hour so that it can chill, and then we can bake them. Here is my first batch going in. I'm pressing too, this isn't really pressing, it's really. Leak proof, airtight seal. I doubt that. So here is our Funfetti batch going in the fridge. is the blue velvet cake mix. And I'm just gonna start mixing this with the spatula, but then I'll start doing it with my hands since that does speed up after a while. But it's just nice to make sure that you're incorporating everything and that there's no powder left at the bottom before you start doing it with your hands. And here is the blue velvet batch going in the fridge. Here is the strawberry mix. And once again, I might do this one with my hands. I'm just gonna do this one with my hands because that just made it go so much easier. Final batch strawberry is going in the fridge. Alright, so now your dough has to chill for an hour before you can cook it. So I'm just gonna clean up the counter and do some homework, and I will see you in a little bit. Alright guys, so my dough has been chilling for an hour now, so we can start putting them in the oven. I preheated my oven to 350 degrees because that's where you're going to need it at. And the first thing I'm going to do is just spray all my pans with Pam to get them ready. Well, because your dough is really sticky, this is the powdered sugar. I just put it into this little clear mug. You only need about a quarter cup of powdered sugar, and because I'm making a... four batches of this, I just put a full cup in here. So I'm gonna put a little bit on my hands and then also just sprinkle some over the dough, and that's gonna help you get it out of the bowl without it sticking and going everywhere. This is how much dough you get. You're supposed to be able to make 30 cookies. So first thing you're gonna wanna do is just lay it out kind of in like a square formation and just make sure that everything is mixed in, that there's no loose powder in the bowl that you missed, kind of stuff like that. And then you're also just going to want to work some powdered sugar into the dough, because trust me, you want a lot of powdered sugar on the dough so it doesn't get so sticky. So I like math, so I know that if the area of this should equal 30, it should be 6 by 5. So let me cut it 6 by 5. Once you have all of your little tiny pieces cut out, these are your cookies. But before you can put them on your tray, you need to roll them in powdered sugar because that helps with stickiness. And now roll it into a ball. Take your powdered sugar, put it in the powdered sugar, roll it around, take it out, roll it in your hands again, and it's good to go. Now I have the Funfetti dough out. Once again, just putting out a bunch of powdered sugar.
Alright guys, so these are the finished blue velvet cookies. And when you're done, you're just going to want to sprinkle a little bit of powdered sugar on top for some decoration to make them look a little prettier. And those are what they look like when they're done. And then also these are all of the other Funfetti balls that still need to go in the oven. These ones I am about to put in, but I thought I'd show them to you first. Here's 1, 2, 3 trays because it's a double batch, so it's going to take a little bit more work to get them done and out of the oven. All right, so I just took the first batch of Funfetti cookies out of the oven and sprinkled the powdered sugar on them, and that's what they look like. And a little note for you guys, the cookies are supposed to look like this when you take them out of the oven. They look really gooey and like a typical cookie. They look like they aren't done, but actually if you look on the bottom, they're brown. I'll try to see if I can pick one up. So as you guys can see, they're brown, really crispy on the bottom. So don't judge them based off the top. Just follow the time instructions that the website gives you, and that's what you should go on.
And now for the final batch, the strawberry gooey butter cookies. Oh, butter sugar, whatever. Yeah.
So here is the second batch of Funfetti that just came out of the oven, And these are all of the strawberry gooey butter balls that are about to go in.
Butter cookies turn out like. And I hope that you guys like this recipe and that you like this video. If you did, make sure to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to this channel so that you are notified whenever I make new videos. And also leave a comment down below telling me some videos to make so I can have some upcoming videos planned for you guys. Thanks! Bye!